Okay, welcome everyone. Welcome, welcome, okay? Welcome to physics. Okay, so today we are using calculus to solve some kinematics what problems, okay? It's a continuation from the previous video. Okay, fine. So, the first example says, a particle starts to move at O, okay? And it travels V centimeters per second, where V is equal to 3t minus t squared, and t is the time in seconds after leaving what? Leaving O. The particle comes to rest at A. Calculate the value of T at A. So what are you supposed to understand first of all? You must understand the movement of this particular what? The movement of this particular particle. Okay, so you can even assume to say, okay, this is the movement of the particle graph, which is T, O, you can say V here, okay? So meaning a particle might have started from somewhere there, moving like that, not until it comes to velocity where it came to rest at A. You see that happen? So don't forget to say, this is O, where the particle started from, coming to rest, where resting means at rest, V is going to be what? At zero, meaning there is no velocity. The velocity is what? Is zero, okay? So at O, the velocity is zero. Now, you should know that at O, velocity is at zero. You understand that? That is 0 meters per second. You see that? Eh? So now, since now we want to find the time at A, we are now going to use this particular function to say V equals 3t minus t squared. You see this? Eh? Then now, you said at what? At O, V is what? Is 0. So let's put 0 here. 0 equals 3t minus t squared. You see that? Eh? So let's commute. Commuting, we are going to have 3t minus t squared is equal to 0. Let's now come to factorize here, okay? What is so common here? We can say t is common. 3t into 3t, we have 3 remaining minus t into t squared, that is what? T is equal to 0. So in this case, we have t is equal to 0. You see that? And what else do you have? You say, oh, you have 3t, that is 3 minus t is equal to 0. Now, meaning that when you take t the other side, you are going to have 3 is equal to t, meaning t is equal to 0. You see that? Eh? Now, look at this. What does it mean? That means at O here, you see that? At O, time is 0, which is here. You see that? Eh? Then, at position A, at rest, where it came to rest at A, time is what? Time is calculated to be 3 here. We said t is equal to 3, so it is 3 here. So it is what? So at time at A is t is equal to 3. You see that? Eh? So 3 seconds. So this is the point. Meaning the time which was here, it was what? 3. Are you able to see that? Okay, that is fine. So this is the way you are supposed to calculate this question. So let's go to question number 2. Okay? So we are going to say, okay, so the second example is here. Calculate acceleration A centimeters per second squared at A. So which means they want to calculate this acceleration. You see that, right? This is the acceleration they want you to watch to calculate. Now, how do you calculate this particular acceleration? So acceleration, don't forget that when you are looking for acceleration, you are supposed to derivate the function of what? Of velocity. So how do you derivate? You have a formula of acceleration is equal to dv over dt. You see this, huh? So meaning using the formulas that I've given you below there, okay, so we are going to say acceleration is equal to, I'm going to get this particular coefficient, which is 3, Then the power of this T, it's 1. Then I'll copy T, T to the power 1 minus 1. Then I've got minus 1 as a coefficient here. Then power is 2. Then we have T to the power 2 minus 1. Okay. So we have got acceleration is equal to 3T 0 to the power 0, because we have subtracted there. 3 times 1 is 3. Then T to the power 0. Then negative 1 times 2 is giving you negative 2. T to the power 1, okay? 2 minus 1 is 1, okay? So in this case, we have acceleration is 3. Then t to the power 0 is what? It's 1 minus 2t. So acceleration is equal to 3 minus 2t. But don't forget that acceleration at A, you see that, eh? From A to what? From O to A. Time is what? At A, you see that? Time is equal to what? Is 3. At A, time is 3. So meaning in this particular acceleration, we are supposed to substitute, eh? Which is acceleration is equal to 3 minus 2. Then where there is T, we are going to replace the time, which is 3 there. So we have got acceleration is equal to 3 minus 6. You see that, eh? Then you have got acceleration is equal to negative what? 3. That is centimeters per square seconds, okay? So this is the answer, the acceleration I expected you to what? To find, okay? Alright. So we can go quickly to the third one, okay? We can go quickly to the what? To the third one, okay? So we are okay. So we are now saying that 3 on this one, we are now saying the distance, calculate the distance x centimeters from O to A. Okay, so now here what they are trying to ask us to do is to find the distance from O to A, okay? So the distance they're trying to say is this distance, which is here, okay? The one that I'm trying to shade here. But how do we find now this particular distance? So the distance is found by integrating the function of what? Of velocity, you see that, right? So we're going to say distance, given that say the distance is x, so meaning we're going to say x is equal to the integral of v dt. You see this, huh? V dt, okay? So now let's go. X is equal to, we are going to say 3t to the power 1 plus 1 over 1 plus 1. We have minus t to the power 2 plus 1 over 2 plus 1 plus c. Okay, so in this case, we are now going to say x is equal to 3t to the power 2 over 2 minus t to the power 3 over 3 plus c. Now, don't forget to say we have already found this, but don't forget that At O, distance is what? Is zero. This is when it is starting, actually, because this particular vehicle started from O coming to A. So at O here, distance is what? Distance is zero. So we are going to say at O, x is going to what? It's going to zero. You see that, eh? So let's go. We are saying that at O, x is 0, and also time is still at what? At 0. Time is at 0 here, okay? So we are going to say time is equal to 0. So now, let's substitute these particular values into this particular expression so that at least we can find the value of C. So we are going to say 0 there, replacing 0. 0 distance is equal to 3. T is 0. To the power 3, to the power 2, sorry, over 2, minus 0 to the power 3 over 3 plus C. So if you check nicely, anything to the power 0, when you multiply any number by 0 is 0. Okay, so we are having 0 is equal to 0 plus what? Plus C. So what does it mean? It means C is equal to what? 0. You see this, eh? So x equal to, so we are now going to copy this particular equation of us to say x is equal to 3t squared over 2 minus t to the power 3 over 3. So where there is a c, I'm going to replace 0. So which is, I was supposed to write plus 0, but it's just what? Nothing, okay? So now, don't forget that now, at O, distance was 0. And the time was what? Time was 0. Now, at A, the distance, the one that we are now finding, the final distance altogether now, okay? From O to A. So at A, time was what? Time was 3. So we are going to say, at A, time was what? 3. So in this particular equation of us, we are now going to say x is equal to, replacing now, 3, t, we have known that t is what? Is 3. 3 to the power 2 over 2. Okay, minus 3 to the power 3 over 3. So x is equal to 3 times 3 because of a square is 9. 9 times 3 is what? 27 over 2 minus 3 times 3 times 3. The answer is 27 over 3. That is giving us 9 over 1. So how do we find x is equal to, common denominator is 2. So 2 into 2 is 1. 1 times 27, 27. Minus 1 into 2, 2. Okay. 2 times 9 is 18. So where you say x is equal to 27 minus 18 is 9 over 2. So where you say 2 into 9 is giving us 4.5 what? Centimeters. And this is the distance which was covered from O to A. Okay, so thank you so much. Allow me to go to the third example. Third example. So here, this distance you have found here is 4.5 centimeters. So that is the distance here, okay? So we are now going to say, we want now to calculate the total distance covered from the time when the time was 0 to the time where it was 4. So if we try to approximate from our only graph here, we can see to say 4 is somewhere here. This is 0, 1, 2, 3, somewhere 4 here, okay? So we can say this is somewhere 4, okay? So it means this particular curve is estimated, say it went like that. Okay, like that. Then now, covering this particular distance at 4. So it means this is the distance they want us to find all together. So the total distance they are trying to ask us to find is this distance together plus this distance. You see that, eh? This distance and this distance. So already, don't forget to say, we already have this distance from O to A. We have said the distance is what? 4.5 centimeters, okay? So now, it's now our task to start solving this particular distance, which is just here, okay? So that when we find this distance, we add to that. Then we would have found what? the total distance, okay, covered. So now let's go. Here what we are going to do is we are now going to integrate, because it's more like from here to here we have the limits, okay? So now we are now going to say, for us to find the distance, we're going to say distance is equal, total distance is equal to the integral of limit 4, which is the upper limit 4, which is the lower limit 3. Then we are derivating what? We are integrating v dt, okay? So that's what we are doing. So now we are now going to say our x is, when we integrate our function here, we are coming to find that it is 3t to the power 2 over 2 minus t to the power 3 over 3. Okay? We have our 4 here, our 3 here. Okay? So, we are now going to open, we are going to subtract now the upper limit. We are going to subtract the lower limit from the upper limit, okay? So we are going to draw to right two separate brackets of the upper and the lower limit, okay? So we are going to copy the same. This limit is going to be 4, this one is going to be 3. So we are now going to do this. 3t to the power 2 over 2 minus t to the power 3 over 3. The same way you can also write this one. We are going to say 3t to the power 2 over 2 minus t to the power 3 over 3. You see that, right? So in this case, okay, so we are going to say x is equal to, we place where there is t, we put this particular 4, okay? So we have 3, 4 to the power 2, okay, to the power 2 over 2, okay? Then we have also minus 4 to the power 3 over 3. Minus, in this bracket we are now going to place where there is t, we put 3 there, it will be 3 to the power 2 over 2 minus 3 to the power 3 over 3. Okay, so our x is, we are going to say 4 times 4, it's 16 times 3, that is 48. 48 divided by 2. 48 divided by 2 is giving us 24. Okay? So we are going to say 24 here minus. We are now going to say 4 times 4 times 4. It's giving us 64. Okay? 64 over 3. Okay, minus, we are now going to say the 3 times 3 is 9, 9 times 3 is 27, 27 over 2, minus, we are saying 3 times 3 times 3 is 27, 27 divided by 3 is 9, over 1. So in this case now we can find the denominators. Common denominator is 3. So we are going to say 1 into 3 is 3. 3 times 24 is 72. Minus 3 into 3 is 1. Times that gives us what? 64. Okay? Minus common denominator here is 2. 2 into 2 is 1. 1 times 27 is 27. Minus 1, that is 1 into 2 is 2, 2 times 9 is 18. Okay, so in this case, x is you subtract here, say 72 minus 64, you are finding We are finding 8. 8 over 3 minus, we are subtracting there. 27 minus what? Minus 18 is giving us 9. 9 over 2, okay? So in this case, when we say common denominator is what? Is 6. 3 there is 3 there is 2. 2 times that is 16. Minus 3. 3 times 9. 3 times 9. 3 times 9 is 27. So when you say 16 minus 27, what answer are you getting? We are getting the answer to be 16 minus 27, we are getting to say it's negative 4. X is negative. Negative 7 minus 6 is 1. Then 2 minus that becomes 11. 11 over 6. So this one, when we divide, what answer are we getting? We are saying that it is 6. It's negative 6 into there is 1. Remainder 5 into 50 into 5 point into 50 it's 8. Okay, it's 8. Remainder 2 into 6 into 20 is 3. Okay, these are what? Meters. So it means this distance is negative because it's found in the negative what? Negative quadrant, or negative, or it's below the what? The particular x axis. Okay, so this is the distance that we have found, which is this one. So this distance, it is 1.83 as centimeters. Okay, centimeters. So now this one, it's in this negative is indicating to say it's in the negative region. Okay, negative region. That is the negative which is there. So now, how do we find out the total distance covered? We are going to say now the total distance covered. We are going to say it's this 4.5 plus, we are going to add, that is 1.8. That is 1.8. 3. When you add, it's giving you 3. 3. Then it's giving also 3 point. This plus that is 5 plus 1 becomes 6. So which means your answer is 6.33 centimeters. This is the total distance which we wanted altogether. Okay. So thank you so much, but don't forget to subscribe, okay?